Service library one where it is mentioned. Oh, there are two things actually. See what I did actually. There is a user service one. I have given the name as user detail here. I created a service in a different location. I service one. And here user response, this is something else. And user detail, that's true. User SVC is true. Now, if I'm going to the I service one, here I have used a user repository. Here I service one. Okay. So let me delete this file now. Okay, now this is the service contract interface and everything is coming. Let's run it again once again. Still, this is service one is ready. Double click on it. User detail. Okay, this is the user detail. Specify the class. So better is create a new service. I'll just modify the existing one. That is why it is showing. The thing which you are seeing right now, it is nothing but a self-hosting part. See, I am getting some ethics here. If I'm trying to, I'll show you in detail. No worry. See, I'm getting a one service here. Now, let's add this. Copy this URL. Service is still running. Going up project, I'm just removing this one for now. Okay. Understood the concept, I'll tell you frankly. We are also implementing the WCF services in our application in the .NET Core MVC. Okay. I'll show you that one also. User client something, creating an object. Adding the references, click on OK. Service is being added. Edit the web project first. I'm creating an object of the user client which I have created here or added it. User client dot. What was the class? See, there are two, three things. I created a user repository client. I just created an object of this class. Equals to end equals to new user class. User repository client dot. I can use a method called add user. I can get user details, get user by ID, or let's do that. It is expecting something from me. Okay, so whatever the things which I have implemented, it is expecting some parameters or returning something data. User request I have written. I'll do get user details. It is expecting me and expecting the user request object. So what I'll do, user client. User client dot user request equals to new request dot city, for example, text box one dot text. I'm just passing my hard coded value. Request dot email. I'm searching the record based on these two parameters or any of one of them.
Okay.
Email ABC something. Okay. ASB. Anything. What this method is expecting from me? basic user request object. So user request for object which we have created, the request one. Place it here itself. Might be it is returning huge amount of data for me. I'll just capture it. LST response. Here I'll get the data. Then you need to check once you got the data. LST response dot. If it is success, then only the data or process the records. What I did here, if you see, I didn't specify. Actually, I have to specify user response dot is success equals to. Let's run it this program first, and we'll see. Clicking onto the button, coming here, press F10. Get something free. I'm getting the details here. It's abc.com or username is .com. Based on the thing is success, then I can bind it. The same approach you have to follow with the web API. If you understood this concept, how I have created a user request object, user response object, that's it. Nothing will be changed in the web API or RESTful services. Everything will be same, I'll tell you. We have 5 projects in the web APIs only. And I'll show you that one also, then you can understand the thing which I'm sharing you, that's totally the real time, and the other country, South African country, who have developed that project, it was awesome. Everything is same. And you have to follow in this way only for the web APIs. The same concept there, you also have in the web API, you have to create the interface. You have to create the classes. And then you can return to a particular action method by using action method, then that's okay. You don't need to go for creating the operation contract and service contract top of that particular classes. You don't worry about those things. But rest of the things will be same to everyone. This is the way of getting the data from the user service. For example, if you wanted to add a record in the database, so what I already created a user request object. Okay. User request client dot. I'm getting a method called add user. I can pass this user request object. I wanted to add this record, city and email, to the database. So I can pass this request. And in the service side, you have to write a code for inserting the data into the database here itself. You have to write it here. Create a connection with the database, add the record in the database. That's it. Akshay, is that clear?
Yes.
Any doubt? So now I'll tell you one thing. Whatever we did, you guys do at least one program for me with ADO.net. If you are not able to do, let me know. I'll do it. But try or make a practice. And send that sample to me, so I'll check what is the issue. Because this time, because now we are going to learn a lot of things like which you have to work on the applications. Whatever we did, we are going to repeat these things. See, we already did in ADO.net, how can we create the response object and all those things. But again, we are going to do it again. Okay, so it will make you comfortable on writing the codes. So just do it one more time. Create one WCF service, okay, and get it the data and display it onto the grid view. That's it. Getting my point? You have to do it like this only. This is the way of creating the WCF service. Tomorrow I'll share you my WCF services which we have created, and everything is same.
Okay, sir. Tomorrow what time?
Tomorrow, Akshay, 8 o'clock.
Evening, right?
Yes.
Evening.
Yes.
Everybody.
What about Sunday, sir? Sunday.
We'll talk about Sunday tomorrow. Okay, just join tomorrow first, 8 o'clock.
Okay.
And Sakshay, don't miss any session from today onwards. Okay. Try to be available at least on weekends. Okay. So whenever then we can discuss in later. But try to do this program from your end. Okay. So we'll see you tomorrow.
Yeah.
Okay. Thank you, Suresh. Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Good night. Bye-bye.
Thank you. Bye-bye.